If you're a photographer and you're brand new and you're wondering, what do I focus on? What do I learn first when it comes to technical skill? In this video, I'm going to outline the top three technical skills that every photographer should focus on and in what order. Hey there, and welcome to my YouTube channel. I am Katelyn James. I'm so excited that you're here. This is a place where we empower and equip photographers to build profitable and purposeful businesses while also letting you see a little bit into the behind the scenes of our day-to-day life. I am so excited about this episode because we get so many questions from beginner photographers saying, what do I learn first? What do I focus on first? I need to first say this. I do think that every professional photographer, when you start your business, you need to start your business and be legally legit. Like, you need the contracts. You need to have a professional website. You need to know how to start a business with your state in a professional way. But that is putting the cart before the horse, in my opinion. You have to know how to do what you're being paid to do before you ever launch a business. And so when it comes time to launch your business, that's a whole other video. Actually, it's a whole nother course talking about how to launch your business in a professional way. Let's just focus on the technical side, because the technical side is what allows you to produce the work that people actually want to pay you for. When you're getting started as a photographer, you have got to start with some type of portfolio, because no one's going to hire you if you just say, hey, I like taking pretty photos, and they're like, okay, here's my money. You have to have something to show for your passion, and you have to have something to show people in order for them to invest. And so that's why I think it's important to focus on these three technical areas for a season of time before you launch into a full-blown business. So what do you start with? Number one, you need to start with understanding lighting. If you don't understand light, you're going to flip your whole experience upside down. If you don't understand light, then your editing is going to suffer. If your editing suffers, then all of a sudden your workflow suffers. And then before you know it, you can charge great prices, but you're not making any money because you're editing for hours and hours and hours. So the foundational technical skill that every photographer has to focus on first is how to understand light. Now, I'm a natural light photographer. It could be for you that you really want to understand off-camera flash and you're passionate about that. That's great. It's still in the category of lighting. You have to understand how light and dimension and contrast and highlights and shadows and backgrounds and foregrounds, how it all works together to create beautiful imagery. And for me, this started in my college dorm room. I started taking pictures of my college roommates with my Canon Rebel. I had a kit lens, and I quickly learned, hey, you know what? Lighting wise, this something isn't working for me. And I quickly found out I needed to invest in prime lenses. Prime lenses allowed more light into my camera. It allowed me to shoot in lower light situations. It also allowed me to get that creamy, bokeh filled, high compression background that I saw in other people's work and I just loved. So I found my prime lenses and I started practicing in natural light. I started figuring out, okay, why are there dark shadows under the eyes? Why does the skin look green? Why do those trees look so beautiful when I look at them, but through my camera, it doesn't look right? Like, what is playing into all of these struggles? And it had everything to do with lighting. When you learn light, you set yourself up for success technically as a photographer across the board. There's so much to learn about understanding light. That's the first thing you focus on. Second technical thing you focus on is how to edit. Because even when you're getting started and you're learning in the right order, so you're learning light first, which is, that is perfect. That's exactly what you should do. Even when you learn light first, you still aren't going to be perfect all the time. And so you need to understand an editing process, because the editing process, even though it will be easier when you learn the technicalities of light first, it's still a huge part of what determines your style. Poor editing, dramatic, heavy editing that's over the top and just too much, it can devalue your work. You can do all this hard work learning natural light, learning what equipment you want to use, learning your style when you're actually shooting. But then if you don't understand editing, it can just derail your entire process. So lighting first, then you start to practice editing. Now, obviously, I am speaking to beginners. So I just want to say really quickly, you want to edit in Lightroom and you want to be shooting in RAW. If you are not shooting in RAW, then you are going to struggle to edit because all of your file, all of your images information has been compressed into a JPEG file and you don't have any capabilities to adjust all aspects of that image's data. And so when I'm editing in Lightroom, when I first started, I remember thinking, everyone says I need to edit in RAW and I don't get it because RAWs, they seem to look so flat and so dull. You can change everything about a RAW image. You can't affect a lot of change editing a JPEG image. So if you're going to be a professional photographer, shooting in RAW is something that you have to do it. You just take my word for it. You will save yourself a lot of time and a lot of headache in the editing process if you start shooting in RAW now. So first is lighting. Second is editing. The third thing you need to focus on technically is posing. Why is that? Because when you start to actually work with clients and you want people to help you build your business naturally, like you don't want to have to spend thousands of dollars going in debt, doing ads and marketing in the traditional way. You want people to love working with you and you want work that shows that you know how to capture people in a genuine way. When that is the case, then all of a sudden your business starts to grow and you don't have to do anything except keep doing the amazing job that you're doing. Keep giving your clients the experience that they love. Posing is, yes, it's about the end result of the technical image. You want your clients to look natural. You want them to look as thin as possible. You want them to look joyful and genuine. But ultimately, really, posing is a marketing strategy. Posing is a marketing strategy. So when you start learning the technicalities of light, right, you can practice that on anything. Once you start having clients or you start having friends that you're going to take pictures of and learn with real people, that's awesome. Editing happens in your office. It happens behind the scenes. Posing is when we start entering into the professional realm because you are starting to realize, okay, I grasp light. I know how to edit these photos. I'm determining my style and it's starting to build up and I'm getting really excited. But before I launch into a huge business endeavor, I want to know how to make people feel amazing in camera. So lighting first, then editing, then posing. This is the order that we encourage our photographers to actually take our courses. So another question we get all the time is, hey, I want to get started and I want to learn from you and I want to take one of your big courses, but I don't know what to start with. Our recommendation is to take the lighting and locations course first. Why? Because it is our most popular course. We see the most dramatic changes from people's work from that course because it is a technical lighting course. It is teaching you how to get the best light in camera. It's fixing all those problems I mentioned before about why are there dark circles under my client's eyes? Why does the light look so bad? Why can't I get that glowy, bright skin that so many other photographers get? Why can't I control the sun? The haze is out of control. What do I do to get the look that I want in camera? Lighting and locations teaches that. And then once you learn that, then you bring it into Lightroom and you start learning how to edit through the KJ Consistency course. So we recommend lighting and location, KJ Consistency course, and then we recommend the posing course. And the reason why we recommend in that order is because the KJ Lighting and Location course goes hand in hand with the Consistency course, and you can create a beautiful workflow. The Consistency course is not only editing, it's workflow, and it allows you to establish this groundbreaking workflow that allows, I edit my weddings and get them on a blog post within 48 hours of shooting it. It's amazing. It is hard work, but it allows me to get my life back and it has saved me from burnout. How am I still a photographer 12 years in when most photographers shut down their businesses between year 4 and year 5? Definitely by year 8. How do I still love what I do? Because I know my systems and I have a workflow that has saved me from burnout. And so that's why I think it's so important for photographers to learn how to shoot with lighting and locations, then learn how to edit and create a systematized workflow that works for them and gives them their life back. And then last but not least, you start to learn how to create an experience for your client through the KJ Posing course. The KJ Posing course is about technical poses. It's about how to create a system when you are working with your client. So to have something that you can work through in your mind so you never draw a blank. So the four core poses, the posing evolution, having different stages within the posing evolution, having different varieties of arm placement and emotions. There's a whole system that I teach and I love it because ultimately, even though people are getting genuine images, The bigger goal of the KJ Posing course is to create an experience for your clients that allows them to market for you after their shoot. It's amazing. It allows you to skip over the first wave of how do I get people to find me? How do I get people to actually pay me? When you have posing strategy and you have posing education that creates an amazing experience, those people market for you. And it's awesome. So just to recap, you want to learn about lighting first. That is going to be the number one way to catapult you forward. Second, edit. Learn Lightroom in and out. Don't just learn a few sliders. Learn the entire program. Because when you learn the entire program, you can fix pretty much anything. Different struggles and different problem areas, you will learn how to fix it all when you're within Lightroom. And you can learn that in the KJ Consistency course. Last but not least, you have to learn how to pose and create an experience that your clients will rave about. Take every opportunity you can to put yourself in a position where you're challenged and where you have to figure it out. If you struggle to figure things out and it's not coming naturally to you, or maybe it is, but you want to grow as fast as possible, there are three main KJ courses with technical skills packed in. Everything I know about lighting, editing and workflow, and posing are crammed into the KJ Lighting and Location course, the KJ Consistency course, and the KJ Posing course. There are links below if you want to check those out. I also have free classes online that you can actually watch and learn for free just to see if this type of information and the way that I teach fits the way that you like to learn. So I hope you enjoy this. I will see you next time.